A fiddler on the roof. It sounds crazy, no? But here in our village of Oratevka, you might say every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do they stay up there if it is so dangerous? We stay because Oratevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word. Tradition!
Tradition! Tradition! Tradition! Tradition!
Because of our traditions, we've kept our balance for many, many years. Here in Oratevka, we have traditions for everything. How to sleep, how to eat, how to work, even how to wear clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered, and we always wear these little prayer shawls. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know. But it's a tradition. And because of our traditions, every one of us knows who he is and what God expects him to do.
Who day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers, and who has the right, as master of the house, to have the final word at home? The papa, the papa. Tradition. The papa, the papa. Tradition.
Village, we always have our special types. For instance, in Tava Matchmaker.
Ephraim, I have found the perfect match for your son, a wonderful girl.
Who is it?
Rochelle, the shoemaker's daughter.
Rochelle? But she can hardly see. She's almost blind.
Tell the truth, Ephraim, is your son so much to look at? The way she sees, the way he looks, it's a perfect match.
And Reb Nachum, the beggar.
Alms for the poor.
Here, Reb Nachum, is one kopeck.
One kopeck. I had the bad week.
And most important, our beloved rabbi.
May I ask you a question?
Certainly, my son.
Is there a proper blessing for the Tsar?
A blessing for the Tsar, of course.
May God bless and keep the Tsar
far away from us.
There are others in our little village. They make a much bigger circle. His Honor the Constable, His Honor the Priest, His Honor many others. We don't bother them, and so far, they don't bother us. But amongst ourselves, we get along perfectly well. Except there was that one time when he sold him a horse, but he delivered a mule. But that's all over now. Now we live in simple peace and harmony. Tradition, tradition. Without our traditions, our lives would be a shaking, is it? As a fiddler on the roof.
On my head by the stove, foolish girl. Where is Hava?
In the barn, milking.
When will Papa be home?
It's almost Sabbath, and he worries a lot when he'll be home. All day long, riding on top of his wagon like a prince.
Mama, you know that Papa works hard.
His horse works harder, and you don't have to defend your Papa to me. I know him longer than you. He could drive a person crazy. He should only live and be well. Sprinto, bring me some more potatoes. Hava, did you finish milking?
Yes, Mama.
You were reading again? Why does a young girl have to read? Will it get her a better husband? Here.
Mama, Mama, Yenta's coming. She's just down the road.
Maybe she's finally found a match for you, Zaitul.
From your mouth to God's ears.
Why does she have to come now? It's almost Sabbath.
Go finish in the barn. I want to talk to Yenta alone.
Mama, can I go out and play?
You have feet. Go.
Can I go too?
Go too.
But Mama, the men she finds, the last one was so old, and he was bald. He had no hair.
A poor girl without a dowry can't be so particular. You want hair, marry a monkey.
After all, Mama, I'm not yet 20 years old, then.
Do you have to boast about your age? Do you want to tempt the evil eye? Inside.
Golda, darling, I had to see you because I have such news for you, and not every day in the week news, once in a lifetime news. And where are your daughters? Outside. No good. Such diamonds, such jewels. You'll see, Golda. I'll find every one of them a husband, but you shouldn't be so picky. Even the worst husband, God forbid, is better than no husband, God forbid. And who should know better than me? Ever since my husband died, I've been alone, a poor widow, nobody to talk to, nothing to say to anyone. It's no life. All I do at night is think of him, and even thinking of him gives me no pleasure because, well,
You know as well as I do, he was not much of a man. Never made a living. Everything he touched turned to mold. Better than nothing.
Excuse me, is Seidel in the house?
But she's busy, you can come back later.
There's something I need to tell her.
Later.
Oh, Mortal, I thought I heard you.
Finish what you were doing. I said later.
All right.
What does that poor little tailor Mortal want with Seidel?
They have been friends since they were babies together. They talk, they play.
They play. What do they play?
Who knows? They're just children.
From such children, Golda, come other children.
Oh, Mottel, he's a nothing. Yenta, you said...
Oh, children, children. They are your blessing in your old age. But my Aaron couldn't give me any children. Believe me, he was as good as gold. Never raised his voice to me. But other than that, he was not much of a person. So what good is it that he never raised his voice? Anyway, what's the use complaining? Other women enjoy complaining, but not Yenta. Not every woman in the world can be a Yenta. Well, Golda, I must go prepare my poor Sabbath table, so goodbye. It was a pleasure talking our hearts out to each other.
Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Oh, I am losing my head. One day it will fall off altogether and a horse will kick it into the mud and goodbye, Yenta. Of course. The news. It's about Laser Wolf, the butcher. A good man, a fine man, and I don't have to tell you that he's well off. But he's lonely, the poor man. You understand? Of course you do. Anyway, to make it short, out of the whole town, he has cast his eye on Seidel.
My Seidel?
No, the Tsar Seidel. Of course you're Seidel.
Such a match for my Seidel. But Tevye wants a learned man. He doesn't like Laser.
Listen to me, Golda. You send Tevye to him. Don't tell him what it's about. Let Laser discuss it himself. He's a good man, a fine man, a wealthy man. True? True. So, you'll tell me how it goes, and you don't have to thank me, Golda, because aside from my fee, which anyway Laser will pay, it gives me great satisfaction to make other people happy. What greater satisfaction is there? So, goodbye, Golda. And you're welcome.
What did she want, Mama?
When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Finish washing the floor.
I wonder if Yenta found a husband for you.
I'm not anxious for Yenta to find me a husband.
Not unless it's Mortal the tailor.
I didn't ask you.
Vital, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you before they can make one for me.
And then after her, one for me.
So if Yenta brings you a husband...
Oh, Yenta, Yenta!
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people can't decide these things for themselves.
She might bring someone wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And well off.
And important. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look through your book and make me a perfect match.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see.
For Papa, make him a scholar.
For Mama, make him rich as a king.
For me, well, I wouldn't holler if he were as handsome as anything.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark I'm alone, so find me a match of my own.
Since when have you been interested in a match, Hob? I thought you just had your eye on your books.
And you have your eye on the rabbi's son.
Well, why not? We only have one rabbi, and he only has one son. Why shouldn't I want the best?
Because you're a girl from a poor family. So whatever Yenta brings, you'll take, right? Of course, right? Paddle? Paddle? Oh, Paddle, have I made a match for you? He's handsome, he's young. All right, he's 62, but he's a nice man. A thought catch, true?
True.
I promise he'll be happy. And even if you're not, there's more to life than that. Don't ask me what. Paddle! Side to side, but he's a nice man, a good catch, right? Right, you heard he has a temper, he'll beat you every night, but only when he's sober, so you're all right. Did you think you'd get a prince? Well, I do the best I can, with no dowry, no money, no family background. Be glad you've got a
matchmaker, matchmaker, you know that I'm still very young. Please take your time. Up to this minute, I misunderstood that I could get stuck for good. Dear Yenta, see that he's gentle. Remember, you are also a bride. It's not that I'm sentimental. It's just that I'm terrified. Matchmaker, matchmaker, plan me no plans. I'm in no rush, maybe I've learned. Playing with matches, a girl can get burned. So bring me no ring, groom me no groom. Find me no find, catch me no catch. Unless he's a matchless man.
Today, I am a horse. Dear God, did you have to let my poor horse lose his shoe just before the Sabbath? That wasn't very nice. It's enough you pick on me, Tevye. Grant him 5 daughters, a life of poverty. But what did you have against my horse? You know, when things are too quiet up there, I think you say to yourself, let's see what kind of mischief we can play on my friend Tevye.
You're finally here, my breadwinner.
I'll talk to you later.
Where's your horse?
He was invited to the blacksmith's for the Sabbath.
Well, hurry up. The sun won't wait for you. I have something to say to you.
As the good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. In other words, send us the cure. We've got the sickness already. I'm not really complaining. After all, with your help, I'm starving to death. Dear God, you made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So, what would be so terrible if I had a small fortune? If I were a rich man, yabba dabba yabba 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 diddle diddle dum. All day long I diddy biddy bum. If I were a wealthy man, I would have to work hard. Yabba dabba yabba 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 dibba dibba dum. If I were a biddy biddy rich, idle little diddle diddle man, I built a big tall house with the rooms by the dozen, right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof and a real wooden floors below. And there'd be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down, and one more leading nowhere just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And each a loud and honk will sound like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, all day long my diddy bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a bitty bitty rich, idle man, I'd see my wife, my gold there, looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to a heart's delight. I'd have her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. What a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important men in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise them like Solomon the Wise. If you please, Prepepia, pardon me, Repepia, causing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. But I die, boy. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in the synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the eastern wall. And I discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day, and that would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, all day long I diddy bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Go to meet the lion and the lamb. You decreed I should be what I am. Oh, would it spoil some nasty plan if I were a wealthy man?
There he is. Devya, you forgot my order for the Sabbath.
Yes, Reb Mordechai, I had a little problem with my horse.
Devya, you forgot the rabbi's order for the Sabbath.
I know, Reb Bindle.
Devya, you forgot my order for the Sabbath.
This is bigger news than the plague in Odessa.
Talking about news, terrible news from the outside world. Terrible.
What is it?
What does it say?
In a village called Rajanka, all the Jews were evicted, forced to leave their homes.
For what reason?
It doesn't say. Maybe the Tsar wanted their land. Maybe a plague.
May the Tsar have his own personal plague.
Amen.
Why don't you ever bring us some good news?
I only read it. It was an edict from the authorities.
May the authorities start itching in places they can't reach.
Amen.
Why do you curse them? What good will your cursing do? All you do is curse and chatter and don't do anything. You'll all chat your way into the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where are you from?
Kiev. I was a student at the university there.
Aha, the university. Is that where you learn to criticize your elders?
That's where I learned that there's more to life than talk. You should know what's going on in the outside world.
Why should I break my head about the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
He's right. As the good book says, if you spit in the air, it lands on your face.
That's nonsense. You can't close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He's right.
He's right. And he's right. How can they both be right?
You know, you are also right.
He's right. He's still wet behind the ears. Good Sabbath, Tevye.
Good Sabbath.
And the rabbi's order?
So you are from Kiev, Reb.
Perchik.
Perchik. You're a newcomer here. As Abraham said, I am a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
Forgive me. As King David put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
For someone with such a slow tongue, he talked an awful lot.
And the cheese?
Here, take a piece.
I have no money, and I'm not a beggar.
It is a blessing for me to give.
Very well, for your sake.
You know, it's no crime to be poor, Reb Perchik.
In this world, it's the rich who are the criminals. Someday their wealth will be ours.
That sounds nice. If they would agree, I would agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People. Ordinary people.
People like you?
Like me?
Nonsense.
And until your golden day comes, Reb Perchik, how will you live?
By giving lessons to children. Do you have any children?
I have 5. Daughters! Daughters!
Girls should learn too. Girls are people.
A radical.
I would be willing to teach them, open their minds to great thoughts.
What? Great thoughts.
Well, the Bible has many lessons for our times.
I am a poor man, Reb Perchik. Food for lessons. Stay with us for the Sabbath, Reb Perchik. Of course, we don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. As the good book says, when a poor man eats a chicken, one of them is sick.
Where does the book say that?
All right, it doesn't exactly say that, but someplace it has something about a chicken. Good Sabbath!
Good Sabbath.
Through there. Good Sabbath, children!
Good Sabbath, Papa!
Children, this is Reb Perchik. Perchik, this is my oldest daughter.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
You have a very pleasant daughter.
I have 5 pleasant daughters. This is mine. And 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 this is not mine. Perchik, this is Martel Kamsoil. He is the tailor.
So you did me a favor and came in.
This is also mine. Golda, this is Reb Perchik. Perchik is a teacher from Kiev. He'll be staying the Sabbath with us. Children, would you like to take lessons from Reb Perchik?
I'm a really good teacher. A very good teacher.
I heard once the rabbi who must praise himself has a congregation of 1.
Your daughter has a quick and witty tongue.
The wit she gets from me, as the good book says.
The good book can wait. Get washed.
The tongue she gets from her mother.
Motel, you're also eating with us?
Of course,
another blessing. Zaitel, 2 more. Sprintz and Bielka, get washed.
Motel can help me.
Get the table. All right, Hava, you go too. You can wash outside at the well. Tevye, I have something to say to you.
Why should today be any different?
Tevya, I have to tell...
I'm praying.
Laser Wolf wants to see you.
The butcher? What for?
I don't know, only that he says it is important.
What could be important? I have nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, see him and talk to him.
Talk to him about what? If he is thinking about buying my new milk cow, he can forget it.
Tevya, don't be an ox. A man sends an important message. At least you can talk to him.
He wants my new milk cow.
Talk to him.
All right. After the Sabbath, I'll talk to him.
Mortal, Yenta was here.
I saw her.
If they agree on someone, there will be a match, and then we'll be too late for us.
Don't worry, Saitel. I have found someone who will sell me their used sewing machine. So in a few weeks, I'll have saved up enough money to buy it, and then your father will be impressed with me.
But, Mortal, a few weeks may be too late.
But what else can we do?
You can ask my father for my hand tonight, now.
Why should he consider me now? I'm just a poor tailor.
And I'm just the daughter of a poor milkman. Just talk to him.
Saitel, your father says no, that's it. It's final. He'll yell at me.
Mortal!
I'm just a poor tailor.
Mortal, even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness.
That's true.
Will you talk to him? Will you please talk to him?
All right, I'll talk to him. Reptevia!
Where is everyone? Late!
Reptevia.
What is it, Mortal? What is it?
A good Sabbath, Reptevia.
Good Sabbath. Like Esther, may you be deserving of praise. Favor them, O Lord, and keep them from the stranger's ways.
May God bless you and grant you long
life. May the Lord fulfill Habit prayer for you.
May God make you good mothers and
may the Lord send husbands who will care for you. May the Lord protect and defend you.
Orca, Yes, Laser Wolf.
A bottle of your best brandy and two glasses.
Your best brandy, Red Blazer.
What's the occasion? Getting ready for a party?
There may be a party. Maybe even a wedding.
A wedding? Wonderful. And I'd be happy to lead the wedding, you know, make it merry and so forth, for a little fee, naturally.
Oh, naturally. No wedding is a wedding without you and your fee.
Good evening. Vodka schnapps?
Vodka.
Right away.
Good evening, Reb Mordecha.
Good evening, Tevye.
Reb Tevye, what are you doing here so early?
He wants to buy my new milk cow. Good evening, Reb Lazer.
Oh, Tevye, come, sit, have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
So how goes it with you, Tevye?
How should it go?
You're right.
And you?
The same.
I'm very sorry to hear about it.
So, how is your brother-in-law doing in America?
I believe he's doing quite well.
He wrote you?
Not lately.
Well, then, how do you know?
If he were doing poorly, he would write.
Tevye, I suppose you know why I wanted to see you.
I do, Reb Lazer. But it's no use talking about it.
Why not?
Why, yes. Why should I get rid of her?
Well, you have a few more without her.
I see. Today you want one. Tomorrow you may want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
The same as you do with one.
Tevye, this is very important to me.
Why is this so important to you?
Frankly, because I am lonesome.
Lonesome? What are you talking about?
You don't know?
We're talking about my new milk cow. The one you want to buy from me.
A milk cow, so I want to be lonesome. I'm talking about your daughter. Your daughter, Zaitl.
My daughter, Zaitl?
Oh, well, of course your daughter, Zaitl. She comes into my butcher shop every Thursday. She's made a good impression on me, and I like her. And as for me, Tevye, as you know, I'm pretty well off. I have my own house, a good store, servant. Look, Tevye, why do we have to try to impress each other? Let's just shake hands and call it a match. And you won't need a dowry for her. And maybe you might find something in your own purse, too.
Shame! What do you mean, my purse? My daughter, Seitel, is not the sort I'd sell for money.
All right, just as you say, we won't talk about the money. The main thing is, let's get it done with. And I will be good to her, Tevye. I like her. What do you think?
What do I think? I never liked him. Why should I? You could have a perfectly fine conversation with him if it's about kidneys or livers. But on the other hand, not everyone has to be a scholar. If you're wealthy enough, no one will call you stupid. And with the butcher, my daughter will surely never know hunger. I always thought of him as a butcher. But maybe I misjudged him. He's a good man. Try to make her happy. What do I think? It's a match!
You agree?
I agree.
Tevye, that's wonderful. Let's drink on it.
Why not? To you!
No, my friend, to you.
to the both of us.
To our agreement.
To our agreement. To our prosperity. To our good health and happiness. And most important, to life, l'chaim.
L'chaim, l'chaim, to life.
Here's to the father I've tried to be.
Here's to my bride-to-be. Drink, l'chaim, to life, l'chaim. L'chaim, l'chaim, to life.
Life has a way of confusing us.
Blessing and bruising us. Drink, l'chaim, to life.
Go toward the like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie panting on the floor.
How much more can we be joyful when there's really something to be joyful for?
To life, l'chaim. To cycle, my daughter.
My wife! It gives you something to think about.
Something to drink about.
Drink l'chaim to life! Reportka!
Yes, Laser Wolf.
Drinks for everyone!
What's the occasion?
I'm taking myself a bride.
Who?
Tevye's oldest, Zaitul.
Mazel tov!
To Laser Wolf,
the Tevye.
To Zaitul, your daughter.
My wife!
May all your futures be pleasant ones, not like our present ones. Drink l'chaim to life, l'chaim. L'chaim, l'chaim, to life! It takes a wedding to make us say, let's live another day. Drink l'chaim to life! We'll raise a glass and drink a drop of schnapps in honor of the great good luck that favored you. We know that when good fortune favors to such men, it sets a reason we deserve it too. To us and our good fortune, be happy, be healthy, long life! And if our good fortune never comes, here's to whatever comes. Drink l'chaim to life!
Ha ha ha!
Mazel tov! Tutania!
Governor Blazer!
Nice!
Ohio!
To life!
After the marriage, we will be related, and you will be my papa.
Your papa? You know, I always wanted a son, though I'd prefer one a little younger than I am.
Good evening. What's the celebration?
Tevye's marrying off his oldest daughter, Zeitel.
Ah, may I offer my congratulations, Tevye?
Thank you, Your Honor.
Tevye, I have some news that I think I should tell you as a friend.
Yes, Your Honor.
And I'm telling you this news because I like you. You are a decent, honest person, even though you are a Jewish dog.
Thank you, Your Honor. How often does a man get a compliment like that? And then, the news.
We have received orders that sometime soon, this district is to have a little unofficial demonstration.
A pogrom? Here?
No, just a little unofficial demonstration.
How little?
Not too serious. Just some mischief. So that if an inspector comes through, he will see that we have done our duty. Personally, I don't see why there has to be this kind of trouble between people, but I thought I should tell you. And you can tell the others.
Thank you, Your Honor. You're a good man. If I might say so, it's too bad you're not a Jew.
That's what I like about you, Tevye. Always joking. And congratulations again for your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor. Dear God, did you have to give me news like that today of all days? It is true that we are your chosen people, but once in a while, couldn't you choose somebody else? Anyway, thank you for sending a husband for my daughter, Saito. L'chaim!
Now, children, I will tell you the story from the Bible of Laban and Jacob, and then we will discuss it together, all right? Good. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and the beautiful Rachel, and Jacob loved the younger Rachel and asked for her hand. Laban agreed, but only if Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
He was an employer. Now, after 7 years, do you know what happened? Laban fooled Jacob and gave him his ugly daughter Leah instead. So in order to marry Rachel, Jacob was forced to work another 7 years. You see, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust your employer. Do you understand?
Yes, Perchik.
All right, moving on.
Papa isn't up yet?
No, Mama.
Then enough lessons. We have to do Papa's work today. How long can he sleep? He staggered home last night and fell into bed like a dead man. I couldn't get a word out of him. Go clean the barn. Call me when Papa gets up.
That was a very interesting lesson, Perchik.
Do you think so?
Although I don't know if the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
And neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
My little sisters have big tongues.
And what do you know about him except that he is the rabbi's son? Would you be interested in him if he were the shoemaker's son or the tinsmith's son?
At least I know this. He does not have any strange ideas about turning the world upside down.
Certainly. Any new idea would seem strange to you. Remember, the Lord said, "Let there be light."
Yes, but he was not talking to you personally.
You have spirit. Even a little intelligence, perhaps.
Thank you.
But what good is your brain? Without curiosity, it is a rusty tool. Good day, Hoddle.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to a girl. But of course, that's far too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our traditions. Nothing must change. Everything is perfect, exactly the way it
is. We like our ways.
Our ways are changing all over, but here. Here, men and women must keep apart. Men study, women in the kitchen. Boys and girls should not touch, should not even look at each other.
I'm looking at you.
You are very brave. Did you know that in the city, boys and girls can be affectionate towards one another without the permission of a matchmaker? They hold hands together. They even do dances together. Dances like this. I learned it in Kiev. Do you like it?
It's very nice.
Just changed an old custom.
Yes, well, you're welcome. I mean, thank you. I mean, good day.
Good day.
Ilke, Spritz, which one are you?
Hoddle, Papa.
Where is Saito?
In the barn.
Call her out. Perchik, our lessons today.
I think we made a good beginning.
Oh, he's finally up. What happened last night besides your drinking like a peasant? Did you see Laser Wolf? What did he
say? Quiet, woman. As the good book says, good news will stay and bad news will refuse to leave. And there's another saying
that... You can die from such a man.
Seitel, my lad. Come here. You are to be congratulated, Saito.
What do you mean, Papa?
You are going to be married.
Married?
Laser Wolf has asked for your hand.
I knew it.
The butcher?
My heart told me this was our lucky day. Oh, dear God, I thank thee, I thank thee.
And what do you say, Saito?
What can she say? My firstborn, a bride. May you grow old with him in fortune and honor. Not like Fru Masera, that first wife of his. She was a bitter woman, may she rest in peace. But not like my Zeitel. And now I must thank Yenta, my Zeitel, a bride.
Mazel tov, Zeitel. Mazel tov, Zeitel.
What sort of a mazel tov is that? And you, Repurchik, aren't you going to congratulate her?
Congratulations, Zeitel, for getting a rich man.
Again with the rich. What's so wrong about being rich?
Money is the world's curse. It is no reason to marry.
May the Lord smite me with it, and may I never recover. Zeitel knows I only mean for her welfare. Am I right, Zeitel?
Yes, Papa.
There you see.
I see. I see very well.
And you, Zeitel, why are you so silent? Aren't you happy with this blessing? What is it?
Papa.
Tell me.
Papa, I can't marry him. I can't.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, you will.
Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself as a servant. I'll dig ditches. I'll haul rocks. Only don't make me marry him. Papa, please.
But what's wrong with Leza? He likes you.
Papa, I will be unhappy with him. Oh, my life will be unhappy. I'll dig ditches, I'll haul rocks.
But we made an agreement. And with us, an agreement is an agreement.
Is that more important to you than I am, Papa? Papa, please don't force me. I will be unhappy all my days.
All right. I won't force you.
Oh, thank you, Papa.
It seems that you were not ordained to have all the comforts of life, or that your mother and I should have any joy in our old age after our hard work.
Reptevia, may I speak with you?
Later, mortal, later.
I would like to speak with you.
Not now, mortal. I have problems.
That's what I came to talk to you about. I think I can help.
Certainly. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, immortal. Goodbye.
At least listen to him, Papa.
All right. He has a tongue. Talk.
I hear you are arranging a match for Zeitel.
He also has ears.
I have a match for Zeitel.
What sort of a match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit.
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This match was made exactly to measure.
A perfect fit, made to measure. Mortal, stop talking like a tailor and tell me who it is!
Please don't shout at me, Reptevia.
All right, I won't shout at you. Just tell me who is it.
Who is it?
Who is it?
Who is it? It's me. It's myself.
It's him. Himself. Either you're completely out of your mind, or you're crazy. He must be crazy. Who do you think you are arranging a match for yourself? The bridegroom, the matchmaker, the guests all rolled into one. I suppose you even want to perform the ceremony yourself. He must be crazy.
Please don't shout at me, Reptivia. As for being my own matchmaker, I know it's a bit unusual.
Unusual? It's crazy.
Times are changing, Reptivia. The thing is, your daughter, Zeitel, and I gave each other a pledge over a year ago that we would marry.
You gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa, we gave each other a pledge.
They gave each other a pledge? Unheard of! Absurd! They gave each other a pledge unthinkable. Where do they think they are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think they are? America? And what do you think you're doing, you Stitcher? You nothing! Who do you think you are, King Solomon? This isn't the way it's done, not here, not now. Some things I cannot, I will not allow. Tradition! Marriages must be arranged by the Papa. This should never be changed. Oh, one little time you pull out the prop, and where does it stop? Where does it stop? Where does it stop? Do I still have something to say for my daughter?
Or doesn't anyone have to ask the father anymore?
I've wanted to ask you for some time, Reptevia, but first I wanted to save up for my own sewing machine.
Stop talking nonsense. You're just a poor tailor.
That's true. But even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. I promise you, Reptevia, your daughter will not starve.
Now he's starting to talk like a man. But what sort of a match is that? A poor tailor. On the other hand, he is an honest, hard worker. On the other hand, he has absolutely nothing. On the other hand, things can't get any worse for him. They can only get better. They gave each other a pledge, unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge, unthinkable. But look at my daughter's face. She loves him, she wants him. Look at my daughter's eyes, so hopeful. Tradition! All right, children. When shall we make the wedding?
Oh, thank you, Papa!
Reptevia, you will not be sorry.
I won't be sorry. I'm sorry already.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa. Modern children, they pledged their troth. Golda. What am I going to do about Golda? What am I going to tell Golda? Help!
Mortal, you were wonderful!
It was a miracle! A miracle! Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a Daniel once again, stood by his side, and miracle of miracles, walked him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God would frown. But like he did so long ago at Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. When Moses softened Pharaoh's heart, that was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all was that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man today. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a tailor by the hand, turned him around, and miracle of miracles, led him to the promised land. When David slew Goliath, yes, that was a miracle. When God gave us manna in the wilderness, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that the one I thought could never be, God has given you to me.
What is it?
Help!
What?
Help!
What's the matter
help
with you, Tevye? Wake up! Why are you howling like that?
Frumacera, Laser Wolf's first wife, Frumacera, she was here just a moment ago.
What's the matter with you, Tevye? Fruma Sarah has been dead for years. You must have been dreaming. Tell me what you dreamt, and I'll tell you what it meant.
It was terrible.
Tell me.
All right. Only don't be frightened.
Tell me.
This was my dream. In the beginning, I dreamt we were having a celebration of some sort. Everyone we knew was there. And the musicians, too. In the middle of the dream, in walks Signor Grandmother Zeitel, may she rest in peace.
Grandmother Zeitel? How did she look?
Well, for someone who's been dead 30 years, she looked pretty good. Naturally, I went up to greet her.
A blessing on your head. To see a daughter wed.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
And such a son-in-law, like no one ever saw. The tailor Motel Kamsel.
Motel?
A worthy boy is he.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
A pious family.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
They named him after my dear Uncle Mordecai. The tailor Motel Kamsel.
A tailor? She must have heard wrong. She meant the butcher.
I'll tell her. You must have heard wrong, Grandpa. There's no tailor. You meant the butcher, Grandpa, by the name of Laser Wolf.
No! I meant the tailor, Tevye, my great grandchild. My little Zeitel, who you named for me, Mortal's bride was meant to be.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
In heaven it was made.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
A fine upstanding boy, a comfort and a joy. The tailor Motel Kamsel.
But we announced it already. We made a bargain with the butcher.
But we announced it, Grandpa, to our neighbors. We made a bargain, Grandpa, with the butcher Laser Wolf.
No, no, no! So you announced it, Tevye. That's your headache. But as for Laser Wolf, I say to you, Tevye, that's your headache too.
Mazel tov, mazel tov, and such a son-in-law like no one ever saw. The tailor Motel Kamsel.
It was the butcher.
The tailor Motel Kamsel.
It was Laser Wolf. The tailor Motel Kamsel.
About your daughter marrying my husband.
Yes, your husband.
Would you do this to your friend and neighbor, Fruma Sarah?
Sarah.
Have you no consideration for a woman's feelings?
Woman's feelings.
Handing over my belongings to a total stranger.
Stranger.
How can you allow it? How can you let your daughter take my place, live in my house, carry my keys for my clothes, pearls,
how? How can you allow your daughter to take a place?
Pearls,
house,
pearls,
keys,
pearls. Tell me that it isn't true and then I wouldn't worry.
Wouldn't worry.
Say you didn't give your blessing to your daughter's marriage.
Daughter's marriage.
Let me tell you what would follow such a fatal wedding. If Zeitel marries Laser Wolf, I pity them both. She'll live with him 3 weeks. By night, I'll take her.
evil spirit may it fall into the river, may it sink into the earth. Such a dark and horrible dream. And to think it was brought on by that butcher. If my grandmother Zeitel, may she rest in peace, took the trouble to come all the way from the other world to tell us about the tailor, all we can say is that it is all for the best and it couldn't possibly be any better. Amen.
Amen.
A blessing on my head, mazel tov, mazel tov. Like Grandma Zeitel said, mazel tov, mazel tov. We'll have a son-in-law like no one ever saw. The tailor mottel comes oil.
We haven't got the man.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
We had when we began.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
But since your grandma came, she'll marry. What's his name?
The tailor mottel comes oil.
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 Thank you.
Tevye Zeitel is going to marry...
I know! Laser Wolf, the butcher!
No! Mottel, the tailor!
Mottel, the tailor!
That's terrible! Mazel tov, Mottel!
Oh, yes, well, do you have a wedding hat for me?
There's a wolf on his wine, but it's not cheap.
I got his bride. I can get his hat.
Yeah.
Oh, Hava, I'll be back soon. Can you watch the shop for a few minutes?
Of course.
Thank you, Hava.
Thank you.
Mazel tov, Hava.
Mazel tov.
Thank you.
Mazel tov, Java. Mazel tov.
Thank you very much. Please let me pass.
Why? But congratulate me.
All right, stop it.
What's wrong with you?
Just stop it.
Now listen here again.
Goodbye, Sasha. I said goodbye. I'm sorry about that. They mean you no harm.
Don't they? Is there something that you want?
Yes. I'd like to talk to you.
I'd rather not.
I have often noticed you at the booksellers. Not many girls in this village like to read. Would you like this book? It's very good.
No, thank you.
Why? Because I'm not Jewish? Do you feel about us the way they feel about you? I didn't think you would.
What do you know about me?
Let me tell you about myself. I'm a pleasant fellow, charming, honest, ambitious, quite bright, and very modest.
I don't think we should be talking this way.
I often do things I shouldn't. Go ahead, take the book. It's by Heinrich Heine. Happens to be Jewish, I believe.
That doesn't matter.
You're quite right. Good. After you return it, I'll ask you how you liked it. Then we can talk about it for a while. Then we can talk about life and how we feel about things. And it can all turn out quite pleasant.
Oh, Fiedka, can I do something for you?
No, thank you.
Oh, Fiedka, you forgot your book.
No, it's mine.
Thank you, Hava.
Good day, Hava.
Good day.
Fiedka.
Good day, Fiedka.
Thank you.
this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play?
I don't remember growing older. When did they?
When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be so tall?
Was it yesterday when they were small?
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the days. Ceilings turned overnight to sunflowers, blossoming even as we gaze.
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the years.
Words of wisdom can I give them? What can I say to ease their way?
Now they must learn from one another, day by day.
They seem the natural together,
just like two newlyweds should be.
Is there a canopy in store for me?
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly the year.
Thank you.
my friends, we are gathered here today to share in the joy of the newlyweds, Matel and Zaitel. May they live together in peace to a ripe old age. Amen.
Amen.
Ah, here comes our beloved rabbi. May he be with us for many, many years.
Amen.
Amen. Now, I would like to announce that the bride's parents are giving the newlyweds the following. A new feather bed. A pair of goose pillows. Goose pillows and these candlesticks. Now, in our joy tonight, let us not forget those who are no longer with us, our dearly departed, those who lived with us in pain and agony and hardship, and those who died in pain and agony and hardship.
Oh boy.
But enough tears. Let us be merry and content, like our good friend Laser Wolf over here, who has everything in the world except a bride. But Laser has no ill feelings. In fact, he has a gift for the newlyweds he would like to announce himself. Come, Laser Wolf!
As he said, I have no ill feelings. What's done is done. I am giving the newlyweds 5 chickens, 1 for each of the first 5 Sabbaths of their wedded life.
Reb Laser, you are a decent man. On behalf of my daughter and her new husband, I accept your gift. You know, there is a famous saying that goes...
Reb Tevye, I am not marrying your daughter. I don't have to listen to your sayings.
If you would just wait a moment, all I was going to say...
Why should I listen to you, a man who breaks an agreement?
Reb Laser, not now, in the middle of a wedding.
I have a right to talk.
What right? This is not your wedding!
It should have been!
Reb Laser, don't shame Reb Tevye at his daughter's wedding.
But he shamed me in front of the whole village!
Sha! The rabbi! The rabbi!
I say, let's sit down.
We all heard the wise words of the rabbi.
Well, I'd like to sing a little song that...
You can keep your diseased chickens!
You leave my chickens out of this! We made a bargain!
The terms were not settled!
We drank on it!
No,
you go away, we're talking!
The terms were not settled!
What did you drink on it? It's a promise! No,
I had a sign! My own grandmother came to us in a dream!
What sign? What grandfather? My grandfather came to me from the grave and told me that her grandmother was a big liar!
What's with all the screaming? They drank on it. A sign, an agreement. It's all nonsense. Saito wanted to marry Mortal and not Laser.
Earl decides for herself.
Yes. Why not? They love each other.
Love?
Terrible.
A radical.
What happened to the matchmaker?
I say.
I know. Sit down. Sit down.
Musicians, play. A dance. Come on, dance. It's a wedding.
What's he doing?
A chick.
Who will dance with me?
That's a sin.
It's no sin to dance at a wedding.
But with a girl?
That's what comes from bringing a wild man into your house.
He's not a wild man. His ideas are a little different.
It's a sin.
It's no sin. Ask the rabbi. Ask him.
Well, rabbi.
Well, dancing, it's not exactly forbidden, but I...
There you see, it's not forbidden.
And it's no sin. Now, who will dance with me?
Huddle.
It's only a dance, Mama.
Play!
Her dick. Perjig, this is against tradition. No, perjig.
Look at Tevye's daughter! She's dancing with the
the man.
I can see that. And I am going to dance with my wife, Golda. Golda, it's only a dance. It's only a dance. Let's go.
Came at a bad time, Tevye. Sorry. But the orders are for tonight. For the whole village! Go on, play! Play!
Ghosts! Mortal!
Sorry. You understand?
Of course.
Come!
Take him in the house.
What are you all standing around for? Clean up! Clean up!
Dear God, that was quite a dowry you gave my daughter Seitel for her wedding. Was that really necessary? Anyway, Mortal and Seitel have been married 2 months now. They work very hard. They're as poor as synagogue mice, but they're both so happy they don't know how miserable they are. Mortal keeps talking about this new sewing machine. I know you're very busy, God. All those wars and revolutions, floods, plagues, all those little things that bring people to you. Couldn't you take a second out of your busy schedule and get it for him? Hmm? Oh, and while you're in the neighborhood, my horse's left leg is... I'm sorry, am I bothering you? Forgive me, forgive me. As the good book says... Why should I tell you what the good book says?
Please don't be upset, Hoddle.
Why should I be upset? If you must leave, you must.
I do have to. They expect me in Kiev tomorrow morning.
So you told me. Then goodbye.
Great changes are about to take place in this country. Tremendous changes.
So naturally you feel that you personally
Not only me, a great many people. Jews, Gentiles, a great many people hate what's going on. Don't you understand?
I understand, of course. You want to leave. Then goodbye.
Hoddle, your father, the others in the village, they think that what happened at Zeitel's wedding was a little cloudburst. And it's all over, and it will be peaceful again. It won't. Horrible things are happening across the land. Violence, pogroms, entire villages being emptied of their people. And it's reaching everywhere, and it will reach here. You understand?
I suppose I do.
I have work to do. The greatest work a man can do.
Then goodbye, Perchik.
Before I go, there is a certain question I wish to discuss with you.
Yes?
A political question.
What is it?
The question of marriage.
This is a political question.
In a theoretical sense, yes. The relationship between a man and woman known as marriage is based on mutual beliefs, a common attitude and philosophy towards society.
And affection?
And affection. This relationship has positive social values. It reflects a sort of unity and solidarity between...
And affection.
Yes, and I personally am in favor of it. You understand?
Yes, I think you're asking me to marry you.
In a theoretical sense, yes, I am.
I was hoping you were.
Then I take it you approve. And we can consider ourselves engaged even though I'm going away? I'm very happy, Hoddle. Very happy.
So am I, Perchik. What's the matter?
I used to tell myself that I had everything, but that was only half true. I had an aim in life, and that was everything, but now I even have you. I have something that I could die for, someone that I can live for too. Yes, now I have everything, not only everything, I have a little bit more. Besides having everything, I know what everything's for. I used to wonder, could there be a wife to share such a difficult, wandering kind of life?
I was only out of sight, waiting right here.
Who knows tomorrow where our home will be?
I'll be with you, and that's home enough for me.
Everything is right at hand, simple and clear. I have something that I could die for, someone that I can live for.
Yes, now I have everything. Not only everything, I have a bit more. Besides having everything, I know what everything's for.
And when will we be married, Perchik?
I will send for you as soon as I can. It will be a hard life, Hoddle.
But it will be less hard if we live it together.
Yes.
Good evening.
Good evening, Reptevia. I have some bad news. I must leave this place.
When?
Right away.
I'm very sorry to hear about that, Perchik. We'll all miss you.
But I have some good news. You can congratulate me.
Congratulations! What for?
We're engaged.
What?
Yes, Papa, we're engaged.
No, you're not. I know. You like him and he likes you, but you are going away and you are staying here. So, have a nice trip, Perchik. I hope you'll be very happy and my answer is no.
You don't understand, Papa.
I understand. I gave Mortal and Saito my permission to marry, so you feel you also have the right. Perchik, I like you. You're a good man. So go in good health, and my answer is still no.
Papa, you don't understand.
You're not listening to me, Hoddle. We will find you someone here in Anatevka.
Reptevia.
What?
We are not asking for your permission, only for your blessing. We are going to be married.
You're not asking my permission.
But we would like your blessing, Papa.
I can't believe my own ears. My blessing for what? For going over my head. Impossible! At least the Saitel and Mortal, they asked me, they begged me. But now, if I like it or not, he'll marry him. So what do you want from me? Go on, be wed, and tear out my beard and uncover my head. Tradition, they're not even asking permission from the Papa. What's happening to the tradition? Oh, one little time you pull out the thread, and where has it led? Where has it led? Where has it led? To this. A man tells me he's getting married. He doesn't ask me. He tells me. But first, he abandons her.
He is not abandoning me, Papa.
I will send for her as soon as I can. I love her.
Love. It's the new style. On the other hand, our old ways were once new, weren't they? On the other hand, they decided without parents, without a matchmaker. After all, did Adam and Eve have a matchmaker? Yes. Yes, they did. And it seems these two have the same matchmaker. They're going over my head, unheard of. Absurd, for this they want to be wed. Unthinkable. I'll lock her up in her room. I shouldn't, I could. But look at my daughter's eyes. She loves him. Tradition! All right, children. You have my blessing and my permission.
Oh, thank you, Papa. You don't know how happy this makes me.
What else could I do?
Thank you, Papa.
What am I going to tell your mother? Another dream?
Perhaps tell her that I'm going to visit a rich uncle, something like that.
Please, Perchik, I can handle my own wife. Golda! Golda!
Hello, Golda. I've been talking to Hoddle and Perchik just now.
Well?
And, well, they seem to be very fond of each other.
Well?
Well, I have given them my permission to become engaged. I have to go inside and...
Just like this without even asking me?
Who asks you? I'm the father.
Who is he? A pauper. He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
I wouldn't say that. I hear he has a rich uncle. He's a good man, Golda. I like him. He's a little crazy, but I like him. And what's more important, Hoddle likes you. Hoddle loves him. So what can we do?
Do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you? With our daughters getting married and this trouble in the town, you're upset, you're worn out. Go inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
Gold, I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
You're a fool.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you? For 25 years, I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children, milked the cow. After 25 years, why talk about love right now?
Golda, the first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. And so I'm asking you now, I know. But do you love me?
Do I love him? For 25 years, I've lived with him, fought with him, starved with him. 25 years, my bed is his. If that's not love, what is?
So you love me?
I suppose I do.
And I suppose I love you too. It doesn't change a thing, but even so, after 25 years, it's nice to
your sister hobble with that Viet Cung, and it's not the first time I've seen them together.
You saw Hava with Fiedka?
Would I make it up? Oh, and Zytel, I was just at the post office and the postman said there was a letter there for your sister Hoddle.
Wonderful, I'll go get it.
Oh, I got it. Right here. It's from her intended, Perchik.
Hoddle will be so happy, she's been waiting. But it's open.
It happened to be open. Okay. Rivka, I've such news for you. Help me, I'm old. I don't believe.
Mm-hmm.
don't have to wait for the train, Papa. It'll be late for your customers.
Just a few more minutes. Is he in bad trouble, this hero of yours? Arrested? And convicted?
Yes, but he did nothing wrong. He cares nothing for himself. Everything he does is for humanity.
But if he did nothing wrong, he wouldn't be in such trouble.
How could you say that? What wrong did Moses do, and Abraham and Joseph? They had trouble.
But why won't you tell me where he is, this Joseph of yours?
It's far, Papa. Terribly far. He's in a settlement in Siberia.
Siberia? And he asks you to leave your father and mother and join him in that frozen wasteland?
No, Papa. He does not ask me to go. I want to go. I don't want him to be alone. I want to help him in his work. It's the greatest work a man can do, Papa.
But hold on.
Papa. How can I hope to make you understand why I do what I do, why I must travel to a distant land, far from the home I love? Once I was happily content to be as I was, where I was, close to the people who are close to me, here in the home I love. Who could see that a man would come who would change the shape of my dreams? Helpless now I stand with him, watching older dreams grow dim. Oh, what a melancholy choice this is. Wanting home, wanting him, closing my heart to every hope, but his leaving the home I love. There where my heart had settled long ago, I must go. Who could imagine I'd be wandering so far from the home I love? Yet there with my love, I'm home.
But who will be there in the wilderness to perform the ceremony?
I promise you, Papa. We will be married under a canopy.
No doubt a rabbi or two was also arrested. Give him my regards, this Moses of yours. I always thought he was a good man. Tell him that I rely on his honor to treat my daughter well. Tell him that.
Oh, Papa. God alone knows if we shall see each other again.
Then we will leave it in his hands. Take good care of her. See that she dresses warm.
Reb Mordka, did you hear the news? A new arrival at Motl and Zeitel's.
A new arrival at Motl and Zeitel's? I must congratulate him.
Rabbi, did you hear the news? A new arrival at Mazel and Zeitel's.
Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov, Zeitel.
Thank you. You got it!
I got it.
It's beautiful.
I know.
Have you tried it yet?
Look.
Beautiful.
I know, and in less than a minute. Look how close it even the stitches are.
Beautiful.
I know. From now on, my clothes will be made perfect. Made by machine. No more handmade clothes.
The rabbi! The rabbi!
Oh, rabbi, come look at my new sewing machine.
Mazel tov.
Rabbi, is there a blessing for a sewing machine?
There is a blessing for everything.
God bless this sewing machine!
Amen.
Amen.
And the baby, how is the baby?
He's wonderful, Mama.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Fiedka.
I came for the clothes.
They're ready.
See, it's our new sewing machine.
I see, I see. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How does it work?
Well, you see, it's an amazing thing. You work with both of your hands?
I will, but I'm afraid.
Hava, let me talk to your father.
No, that would be the worst thing. I'm sure of it.
Let me try.
No, I will talk to him, I promise.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good day.
Good day. What were you and he talking about just now?
Nothing, we were just talking. Papa, Fiedka and I have known each other for a long time.
I would prefer if you and he remain friends from a distance. You must not forget who you are and what that man is.
He has a name, Papa.
Of course. All the creatures on Earth have a name.
Fiedka is not a creature. Fiedka is a man.
Who says he isn't? It's just that he is a different sort of man. As the good book says, each shall seek his own kind. That, translated, means a bird may love a fish. But where will they build a home together,
The world is changing, Papa.
No. Some things do not change for us. Some things never change.
We don't feel that way.
We?
Fiedka and I. We want to be married.
Hava. Are you out of your mind? Do you know what that means, to marry outside of the faith?
But Papa!
No! I don't want to hear any more of this. Never speak to him again. Never speak of him again. Never mention his name again. Do you understand me?
Yes, Papa, I understand.
You're finally here. Let's go home. It's time for supper.
I want to see Martel's new machine.
You'll see it some other time. It's late.
Quiet, woman! Before I get angry. And when I get angry, even flies don't dare to fly.
I'm very frightened of you. After we finish supper, I'll faint. Come home.
Golda! I am the man in the house. I am the head of the household. And I say, I want to see Mortal's new machine now! All right, now let's go. How long can that miserable horse of mine complain about his leg? Dear
God, if I can work on two, why can't he on three? I know. I'm very upset about my horse. He is one of your creatures, and he has all the same rights as I have. The right to be sick, the right to be hungry, the right to work like a horse. And dear God, I am sick and tired of pulling this cart. I know, I know. I should push it a while.
Tevye, Tevye.
What is it?
It's Hava. She left home this morning with Fiedka.
What?
I looked all over for her. I even went to the priest. He said they were married.
Married? Go home. Go there. Go home. You have work to do. I have work to do. We have other children at home. Go home, Golda.
But Hava.
Hava is dead to us. We will forget her. Go. Little bird, little gobbler, I don't understand what's happening today. Everything is all up now. All I can see is the happy child, the sweet little bird you were, Havala, Havala. Little bird, little Havala, you were always such a pretty little thing, everybody's favorite child. Gentle and kind and affectionate, the sweet little bird you were, Havala, Havala. Accept them. How can I accept them? Can I deny everything I believe in? On the other hand, can I deny my own daughter? On the other hand, how can I turn my back
on my faith, my people. If I bend that far, I will break. On the other hand, no.
Tradition.
There is no other hand.
Tradition.
No other. No.
Boys, Golda, both learned boys from good families. Each one just right from the top of the tree. You couldn't do better for your girls.
I don't know, Yenta. My girls are still so young.
So what, do they look like grandfathers? Meanwhile, they'll be engaged. Nothing to worry about later. No looking around. Their future all signed and sealed.
Well, which one for which one?
What's the difference? Take your pick.
Golda, is Reb Tevye home?
Yes, but he's in the barn. Why, is there some trouble?
Call your father.
Go home. Tell your parents I'll talk to them. Go.
What is it? Why are you all gathered together like a bunch of goats? What's the matter?
Tevye, have you seen the constable today?
No. Why?
There are some rumors in town. We thought because you knew him, maybe he told you what is true and what is not.
What rumors?
Someone from Zoladin told me that there was an edict issued in Petch.
Welcome, Your Honor. What's the good news in the world?
So you have company.
They are my friends.
It is just as well. What I have to say is for their ears also. Tevye. How much time do you need to sell your house and all of your household goods?
And why do I need to sell my house? Is it in anybody's way?
I came here to tell you, you're going to have to leave Anatevka.
And how did I come to deserve such an honor?
And not just you, of course, but all of you. First, Tevye, I thought that you might be spared because of your daughter, Hava.
My daughter is dead.
I understand. At any rate, it affects all of you. You have to leave.
But this corner of the world has always been our home. Why should we leave?
Don't know why. There's trouble in the world. Troublemakers.
Like us.
But you're not the only ones. Your people must leave all the villages. Zordin! Rebelevka, the entire district must be emptied!
The whole district?
What have we done?
I've been ordered! Here. It says your people must sell your homes. Be out of here in 3 days!
3 days? What is he talking about?
And you, who have known us your whole life, you would carry out this order?
I had nothing to do with this. Don't you understand?
We understand.
What if we were...
Then you will be forced out!
We will defend ourselves!
Stay in our home!
Fight!
Against our army? I wouldn't advise it.
I have some advice for you. Get off my land. This is still my home. My land! Get off my land!
We should get together with the people of Zoladin. Maybe they have a plan.
We should defend ourselves an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
Very good. That way, the whole world will be blind and toothless.
Rabbi, we've been waiting for the Messiah our entire lives. Wouldn't this be a good time for him to come?
We'll just have to wait for him someplace else. Meanwhile, let's start packing.
I will see you before I leave. 3 days?
I have more than 100 bottles of vodka. What will I do with them?
Where will I go with a wife, a parents, and 3 children?
Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
After all, what have we got here? A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
A pot.
A pan.
A broom.
A hat. Someone should have set a match to this place years ago.
A bench.
A tree.
So what's a stove?
What a house.
People who pass through Anatevka don't even know they've been here.
A stick of wood.
A piece of cloth.
What do we leave? Nothing much. Only Anatevka.
Our forefathers have been kicked out of many places at a moment's notice.
Maybe that's why we always wear our hats.
With Uncle Abram, but he doesn't know it yet.
I wish you and the baby were coming with us.
We'll be staying in Warsaw until we have enough money to join you.
Mottl, be careful with these. My mother and father, may they rest in peace, gave them to us on our wedding day.
Come, children, help me pack the rest of the clothes.
Golda, darling, I had to see you before I left because I have such news for you. Golda, darling, you remember I told you yesterday I didn't know where to go, what to do with these old bones? Well, now I know. You want to hear? I'll tell you. Golda, darling, all my life I have dreamed of going to one place. And now I'll walk, I'll crawl, I'll get there. Guess where? You'll never guess. Golda, darling, what do we say every year after Pentecost? We say, next year in Jerusalem, next year in the Holy Land.
You're going to the Holy Land.
You guessed! And you know why? In my sleep. My husband, my Aaron, came to me and he said, Yenta, go to the Holy Land. So, One way or another, I will get to the Holy Land, and you know what I'll do there? I'm a matchmaker, no? I arrange marriages, yes. So, I'll go to the Holy Land, and I will help our people increase and multiply. It's my mission. So, goodbye, Golda.
Goodbye, Yenta. Be well and go in peace.
Maybe next time, Golda, we will meet on a happier occasion. In the meantime, we suffer! We suffer! We suffer in silence, right? Of course, right.
Come, Golda, we have to leave soon.
Leave, it sounds so easy.
We'll all be together, you'll see. Mortal, Cytel, and the baby, they'll come too. That mortal is a person.
But Hoddle and Perchik, when will we ever see them?
Do they come visiting from Siberia every Sabbath? You know what she writes. He sits in prison, she works all day, he will be set free soon, and together they'll turn the world upside down. She couldn't be happier. All the other children will be with us, you'll see.
Not all.
All. Come, Golda. We need to leave.
I still have to sweep the floor.
Sweep the floor?
I don't want to leave a dirty house.
Well, Tevye, I am off.
Where are you going?
Chicago, in America. My wife, Fruma Setup, may she rest in peace, has a brother there.
That's nice.
I hate him, but a relative is a relative.
Goodbye, Lisa.
Goodbye, Teddy.
Cytel, are they almost finished inside?
Almost, Papa.
Papa! Papa will see you. I wanted to say goodbye to him. He will not listen. Then at least he will hear. Maybe it would be better if I went inside and told Mama.
Papa!
Papa, we came to say goodbye. We are also leaving this place. We are going to Krakow.
We cannot stay among people who can do such things to others.
We just wanted you to know that. Goodbye, Papa. Mama.
Yes, we are also moving. Some are driven away by edicts. Others by silence. Come, Hava.
Goodbye, Hava. Pietka.
God be with you.
God be with you. We will write to you in America if you like.
We will be staying with Uncle Abram.
Yes, Mama.
We will be staying with Uncle Abram. We'll be staying with Uncle Abram. The whole world has to know our business.
Stop yelling and finish packing. We have a train to catch.
I don't need your advice, Golda. Cytel, don't forget the baby. We have a train and a boat.
Goodbye, Papa.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Bottle.
Goodbye, Bottle.
Work hard, Mortal. Come to us soon.
I will, Reptevia. I will work hard.
Although we can leave these?
No, we can't.
All right, we can't.
Stop that! Behave yourselves! We're not in America yet.
All right, children. Let's go.
A magical and beautiful experience. So we'll have Catherine start with hers.
Dana Hoagland.
just want to thank her for being such a big supporter. She like she never hesitates to put in extra time for us, and we definitely could not do it without her, and thank you so much.
How amazing is this set? This is all thanks to Mr. Rich Goss, a.k.a. the captain. Is he here? There he is. Thank you.
This is for our costume designer, Meg, and I don't know if she is here. She's not here, but she worked with all of us getting all these beards on people, getting people dressed like Russians and Jewish people both the same. She's amazing and talented, and she deserves these flowers. So round of applause for her.
And last but certainly not least, Miss Pam St. Clair. Is she here? She helped us with all of, she's our choreographer, she helped us with all of the dances, everything on stage. It was so, come up here, come on. And we couldn't have done any of this without her. So thank you so much, Ms. Pam, here you are.